the management of Royal Orchid, Mr. Amit Jaiswal, who is the CFO at the company, joins us now. Hi, Amit. Good afternoon, and thanks a lot for joining us. There is a lot of euphoria around the hotel stock since the last two trading sessions. News of occupancy rates going up. Could you confirm the same for us?
Yes. See, you are right that last few sessions we have been seeing that hotels overall, the industry is doing well, and believe me, this is happening after a decade. Last decade hotels were not doing that well, but over last 1 year period we have seen a great improvement in the the occupancies of across the hotel, and the leisure hotels also have started doing very well. And we are now sitting at an occupancy of 75%+ over and above the, and the industry also is sitting at almost 70% occupancy. So things are looking great going forward.
Amit, you said for industry the occupancy rate is 70, and for a company like yours is almost 75%. Correct me if I'm wrong. Going into FY19 now, do you see this 75% rate inching higher?
We are quite confident that in FY19 we will be crossing 80% mark.
Okay, and if the occupancy, go ahead.
No, because the demand has grown, whereas and it is overriding the supply. The basic reason for this is that the demand is now overriding the supply, so things are looking great, and occupancy levels are going to go beyond 80% now.
The other big question is that if the occupancy rates are going up, are we also seeing some bit of pricing power coming back to the sector? Have you revised your average room rates?
See, what happens, unless and until the entire market does well, it is difficult to increase the prices. And yes, we have started seeing the improvement in the prices, but this improvement was not that great in last financial year. But we are very confident that the current financial year, the average rates are going to go up by in a range of 8 to 10%, and primarily because now the competition also is sitting at 70% occupancy. So this is the time when we can increase our rates, and things they are going to yield results.
And what was your ARR rate in FY18? If you're expecting an increase in FY19?
FY18, we were in the range of 3,800 across all the hotels put together. Some of the hotels are doing very well. But at the same time, it averages out to around 3,800, which we will see at least 8 to 10% growth in the current financial year.
Okay. Is it possible, Amit, to predict or forecast demand or occupancy rates for a year at large? I'm just trying to get a sense. You might be having a really good period right now.
See what happens in the beginning of the year, we budget the okay, which we have done. So we are forecasting almost 80% occupancy. But what happens, if you really look at how the hotel business works out, is that 50% of my business is closed at a rate which we have finalized last year. Okay, that it goes on calendar year, the RFPs and the corporate rates. So again, the corporate rate change will happen sometime in January. But as far as the 50% inventory is concerned, which is on the open market, which we sell through the groups and, EMC and blah, blah, places, there we will see an increase in the rate, which may be, more than 10% also.
No, Amit.
But averages out to 8 to 10%.
No, Amit, let me qualify. I didn't mean the rates. I meant the occupancy. The occupancy levels,
that's
which
what
are
I'm telling you, occupancy now we are at 75%, and it will go to 80%.
No, my question to you is precisely that, Amit. My question to you is this: that right now, when the either the business travel or the tourism travel is very strong, and you are at about 80% or 75%, whatever the number is, we are in the month of April. Is it possible in your industry to forecast what will happen for the next 11 months on occupancy?
Yes, we can forecast. We can forecast to the accuracy of almost 95%.
Wow, and you believe that occupancy will touch 80% for FY19?
Yes.
Couple that with... Okay, so then the question is, couple the higher occupancy, fairly impressive numbers, I'm very happy for you and your shareholders, and the ARR uptick that you mentioned about 8 to 10% that you believe could come in, maybe higher. What does this mean for financials? Because if these are the numbers that you're talking about, operating leverage would kick in a very big way.
Yes, that's what. If you really look at our results quarter on quarter, you will find that there is a good improvement in the bottom line. Our top line may not be growing that great, but our bottom line is constantly improving, and this will continue to improve because of the two factors. One is that whatever our owned as Yellow Hotels leased asset, we will be getting extra revenue, out of which almost 70% falls goes down to the bottom line. Plus, what is happening, we have signed a lot of managed contracts also, and we continue to do that. So those additional incremental fees will also go to our bottom line. So our bottom line is tend to improve in, if the trend continues like this, then our bottom line will be very stronger on quarter-on-quarter basis, which you will see in the current financial year.
Amit, there was a substantial improvement in your EBITDA margins in the December quarter of almost 24% vis-a-vis the rates of 18 to 20% which we've been seeing in the previous quarters. Will you be able to sustain this kind of run rate in the coming quarters?
Absolutely, we are going to sustain because we have worked a lot on our cost optimization. We have cut down all kinds of frills, and the target is that to create more profits and value for my investors.
So can we expect margins in the territory of 24 to 25% for FY19?
Yes. EBITDA margin is going to grow, and we are very confident about that. Unless at least something, industry, something happens like, some odd incident happens. Things are looking improving for next 3 years. We can forecast that things are going to be great.
A word on your expansion plans, Amit, going into FY19, any new properties that you're looking to launch?
Already we have almost 6 properties in the pipeline, which we are going to open it. And we are very aggressive as far as Tier 1, Tier 2 cities are concerned. And our roadmap is that another 40-50 hotels we have to open in next 3 to 4 years' time.
I would presume by whatever you are saying that your quarter four numbers would also be looking great. I know you might be in a silent period, might not be able to talk everything, but you reckon that the operational improvement would have been quite spectacular in quarter four?
Yes. The operational improvement had been very spectacular. In fact, we have done a lot of revenue management. This once your occupancies are going beyond 70%, the revenue management kicks in, wherein you take decisions on which business to take, which business to lose, what is the segment-wise, each source-wise, what business you are picking it up at what rate. So all those things working, we are doing it, and we are inching towards getting greater heights.
Okay, I don't have the numbers off hand, Amit, but what would the debt situation be at Royal Orchid? And with these numbers, what are you planning to do with the debt?
See, right now in standalone, our debt is at almost 36 crores and the consolidated debt is around 76 crores. See, with these numbers coming in, we will definitely be able to reduce our debt. Probably we are looking at doing some leases with this additional cash flow which will come. We are trying to take over some leased asset, which will add, which will increase our, top line also, as well as it will add to the bottom line. So things, a lot of things are there on the card. Probably in the next ensuing board meeting, at the year-end board meeting, we'll be presenting it to the board for a, roadmap that what way we are going to go going forward.
Did I hear you use the term additional capital? Are you into a capital raising mode?
Additional cash flows which come. Yes, additional cash flows which we are now able to see it. With that, we are also looking at taking some leases because our top line is not growing. Unless until I get some hotel of our own, my top line may not grow that much. So we are looking at some leases which we want to take over so that our top line also grows in at par with the bottom line. And these leases are going to yield a lot of result for the bottom line.
Okay, but last question, Amit, from my end. And again, not an exact number, but more a ballpark estimate. FY19 over FY18, is there a base run rate that you anticipate on the top line? Forget the bottom line. It'll be a factor of a number of things. Just the top line.
Top line, I am very confident that we should be able to add at least 15% on the top line. That these are the estimates. It is very too early to say confidently, but we are quite confident that the things which are going on in the industry, we should be able to add at least 15% on the top line.
All right, Amit, we'll let you go on that note. Appreciate you joining us.